And full arch implants is probably one of the pinnacles, I would say, of restorations and dentistry, because it's one of the hardest things, and it's been traditionally very hard. And thankfully, these days, it's much simpler. I started Institute of Digital Dentistry as like a passion project, and it has grown tremendously over the past few years. I think orthodontics and implants are the best two things in general dentistry. And regarding implantology, we also do a lot of courses, pig jaw courses in New Zealand. But some of us still believe a scanner can't restore this. But, you know, that's just not the case these days. If they tell you that, you know, my scanner can scan full arch implants and it's totally accurate and you don't need anything else, they're probably not telling you the truth, especially if you hear that from someone who's trying to sell you a scanner. You need something predictable. You can't just scan it and then send it to the lab and then, you know, 50% of the time it works. That's not good enough. You need something that's always going to work and you can rely on. The point is that teeth sit in a ligament and they can move around a little bit. And you feel that with full mouth rehab. When you fit all your crowns, you know, sometimes they're a bit tight and sometimes they're a bit light contacts, and then everything kind of just settles in. And anything over 100 microns just doesn't work. You're not going to get a passive fit. And this is fundamentally the issue with scanning full arch implants. So this piece of literature showed that scanners are actually better than impressions. And we kind of know that. In 2025, I hope you all accept that is the truth. This was probably one of the biggest barriers to restoring full arch, because this was a hassle. Before verification jigs, people used to even weld inside the mouth. I'm not joking. Imagine that, a welding unit inside the mouth with all the sparks. That was your verification jig. And I'm sorry to say, guys, it doesn't work. Literature shows it doesn't work. I actually got burnt by this because I'm a really big early adopter in digital dentistry and anything dentistry, really. It keeps changing every single year. And necessity is the mother of all invention, because something major happened in 2010. We got these devices. Many of you who are really into full arch implants may know of this. Some of you who are just starting their implant journey may have no idea. A lot of literature showed that photogrammetry showed superior trueness and precision, meeting misfit thresholds for implant-supported complete full arch prosthetics. And I'll tell you guys, it worked. It solved a lot of issues for us. We never looked back. This was the way to do it. You're talking around $30,000 to $40,000. That equates to us in the around the Tasman, $50,000 to $60,000 for a device that you may use once or twice a year. I always felt like these photogrammetry devices, they're a perfect solution. They're amazing, but too expensive for the average user and too complicated for most labs to know what to do with these files. NEXUS IOS was the first one on the market with this, and they pioneered this idea of horizontal scan body. Great system, works a treat, and I would say it's one of the tidiest full arch implant systems that I've ever tried. And this proves to be a bit of an issue, because many of us, we will already have invested in digital dentistry. Some of these other systems, the screws are not fixed in, so by the time you get the kit out of your sterilization, the screws are everywhere. It's really frustrating and they can fall out during surgery. I've been through all the issues. And one is just generally the profile of these I like quite a lot. Thin at the neck and then they converge out and splay out. The beauty of the TruAbutment system is that it's an open system, like many of these systems that are on the market now. They're all open. They're not locked to scanners, etc. And the whole idea of this, it's a really simple concept. There's nothing super scientific about it. You don't need to stress out. You just have to make these abutments converge in the middle. Now on the lab side, and I put lab side here in red because I don't want to scare you guys, what your lab is going to do is open up this software called TruSuite, and they're going to click on ioConnect, and they're going to do an alignment. Now there's three big benefits that I would say of using a system like this. A, like I mentioned, no extra device. It's changed our life. The other thing is it's much cheaper. So TruAbutment says their RRP of this ioConnect kit is around $3,000 US. That's around $5,000 around Australia, New Zealand. That's about 10 times cheaper than a traditional photogrammetry unit. The other thing is it's a much simpler workflow. one scanner, one software. It's just like scanning regular scan bodies. If we have a methodology that is significantly more accurate than doing it the lazy way, then this is the way we should be doing things. Hand on heart, I don't think I've used my ICAM since the start of the year. It's just sitting there as a backup. It's totally shifted my workflow and my practice, and I totally believe this is the way forward. When it comes to final time, you just unscrew this temp, rescan it with the gold things, rescan it with the TruAbutment ioConnect system, and then put the temp back in, send that to your lab, and they can make you a final. Now comes the big question, you know, how does it compare to photogrammetry? And look, guys, I don't think anyone can argue that photogrammetry is the gold standard. It is. I'm sorry. It still is. It is the gold standard. And everyone in the industry sees it as the gold standard because it's, you know, high tech, I guess. You're using a fancy device and it's got two cameras and you're using all this triangulation. But when is good enough? Like, when is enough research going to show that this works? The other point that I want to mention is, when does nearly perfect become clinically acceptable? The point is that they're never going to get as cheap as, you know, something like a horizontal scan kit. You know, getting this for $5,000 and unlocking this in your practice is kind of crazy. And to me, why I like this company is they're just innovating. I love companies that are changing the way we do things. And a really basic innovation that I really liked is, it's nice to see a company that's actually, you know, they listen to their customers and they're making a change. This is not a thing only done by like maverick dentists and guys who are early adopters. I think this is pretty mainstream now. I wouldn't go higher than 50 microns, basically. Anything worse than 50 microns is bad news. Interestingly, with my piece of literature that I hope to launch soon and publish, don't think of all of them as like crazy accurate. Not all of them are getting like 5 and 10 microns. It's quite similar, if not comparable, to some of these horizontal scan body solutions, which blew my mind when I saw that. The shape of their horizontal scan bodies, they can be kind of annoying, but more importantly, Shining Elite reads the dots. It's not like scanning a scan body. It reads the dots. So it's a lot more technique sensitive. I mean, what I liked about the TruAbutment system, it just felt solid. I don't know. I think they make it out of titanium. I think it's titanium. I don't even know. Whatever it is, it feels solid. The screws stay in. It's easy to position and maneuver around. And that's really all you need from a horizontal scan body system. Thing I will say about the TruAbutment system, and you may hear pushback from your labs, because the one thing about the TruAbutment system is that on the lab side, they're not the most totally open. You still have to get some components from TruAbutment, and some labs like to get third-party components, cheap components. And so they do lock you in lab side. With TRIOS, when you scan the abutments, you have to use Bite. And I know that sounds really weird and dumb. It's just the TRIOS thing, and they're working on fixing it. It's just basically the AI of TRIOS. IDES TRIOS announced a partnership with TruAbutment, and they're working on a workflow specifically for this. So you don't have to do this weird workaround by scanning it in the bite. But that's how you do it.
We hope you find today's session on ioConnect versus photogrammetry was informative and practical for your full-arch workflow.